In this video, we're going to go through a design that we're going to put on the back of a hat. So I want to add an arc to this name. To do that, you can pull in an image of your hat. So I just took a picture of the back and I'm gonna use the backdrop tool. Select my hat. It's pretty large. I can just resize this down. That should be good. So let's click on our text tool and I'm going to do a comma. We can change our font here. If you click into the box, let's do this one. All right, and I might need a little bit of space in between each letter. I can choose that here, the space. Let's do 15% and click apply. They're a little bit more spaced out now. So in order to make this design curve around this hat here, we have the type option. You have normal, circle, spiral, monogram, path, and vertical. We want circle. And we'll click apply, and you can see it placed the letters in this circle. Now I'm gonna center it, and then I can edit the arc by using the green bubble here. So I just want to make sure it is fitting just right over this seam. And that looks pretty good. Let's change it to white so we can see it a little bit better. If I go back to the text tool, I can then edit it a little further. If I want it to be larger, we have the orange option at the top, but let's keep it just like that. And that's how we create letters over a curve. You can always edit the size if you need. You can make it larger any which way. You can angle it, but as long as you have that initial curve on the bottom, you'll be able to stitch this on the back of a hat. So let's actually look at how to adjust on, say, a t-shirt. So I'll create a new file and I want to pull in a shirt. And we want to put a design around the neckline. I'm gonna rotate this. All right. So let's use our text tool. Let's do Chroma. And so here I can then, let's do this a different way. I'm gonna still space these letters out a little bit. I want them all to be evenly spaced. I'm using this key here. You can also manually space them from each other by using your blue arrow keys. And you can then move each letter by clicking on the black diamond. This will allow me to edit the size. Let's say I want the R and the A to be larger than the others. I can also rotate them. So let's rotate these and let's just place them around the shirt. We can do this manually, and you're just kind of arranging them how you want. This, maybe do that. The O we can keep. So this would be a manual way to kind of place your words around the collar of a shirt. Now this looks a little crazy with these larger letters. Another way that you can do this is, let's say we create our word now. And we can also use these green dots to shape the word. I can give it a nice little dip here. Place it around my shirt. We can rotate it if you need. And then if I wanted to further edit, let's say I do want to space them, I can space up here. And then if I wanted to rotate each individual letter after that, it makes a little bit more sense. And so I can place each letter. Now I have a little design that goes around the collar of my shirt. Okay, thank you.